Hardwick House orphanage. I've lived here all my life. That's Grumpy Edna, the cook. That's nice Mrs. Trinkleberry. She looks after the little ones and lives in the village. And the handyman. Oh, I forgot. Miss Addiston fired him. She runs the orphanage. She's horrible. We live by Addiston's rules. No singing, no sweets, no TV. No fun. That's me. Well, actually, no, it isn't. Miss Addiston doesn't even like us reading. It's why I'm hiding in the laundry room. That's me, Molly Moon.
Come on, Molly.
And that's my friend Rocky.
Midnight Feast.
Shush, silly Petula. Mummy's back.
Not so loud. I just see my hair.
Catch up!
What is going on here? Out of bed after curfew, stealing from the kitchen, girls in the boys' dormitory. If you thought it was bad before...
It was me, Miss Addiston. It was my idea.
Molly Moon, the rotten bad apple, I might have guessed. Toilet cleaning duty all week. And all of you, 6 p.m. curfew and fish soup 3 times a day.
This is disgusting.
There's an eyeball in mine. It's staring at you.
Horrible.
Come on, Ruby, it's not that bad.
It smells horrible.
What a thing.
Do we have to eat this, Mrs. Trinkleberry?
Yeah. Thanks to Bog Eyes, we're on curfew and vomit soup all week.
Yeah, Bog Eyes.
Don't you be rude about my food. Put a nice piece of mackerel in there. One of you should find it.
I can't do this.
Anything.
Molly, what's that?
The talent contest. You should enter.
You're brilliant.
Not a chance, Rosa boy. That money is ours.
Nobody leaves.
Shut the front door.
Gonna bring it to your knees.
£300.
That's enough, you lot.
I'd buy loads of sweets.
Little ones, it's time for a nap. Come on, let's go.
Do I have to?
Bye, Jinx.
Bye-bye, Lola.
Bye-bye,
Fisty.
Bye,
Ruby.
Bye. Your boyfriend won't enter the contest.
He's scared. He's not my boyfriend, he's my friend.
Well, he's the only one you'll ever have. Weirdo. No wonder your parents dumped you here.
No one dumped me!
You're right, reject.
I'm not a reject! Who told you that?
Everyone knows it. You better shut up or I make you shut up!
Silence! What on earth is going on? What is this? Talent contest? How dare you bring this nonsense in here and cause this commotion? Punishment obviously wasn't enough, Moon. Dishwashing duty all week. However, think that you can get the better of me, Michael, because I will come down on you like a ton of bricks!
Molly.
Enough bubbles. Let me give you a hand.
Thanks, but I can do this on my own.
Miss Moon.
Put on a happier face. See, you're smiling. You know, we're gonna get out of this place, it's true. Bullies are just such a waste.
You know, you really should enter the talent contest.
I can't sing in front of other people.
Rubbish. You sing to me all the time.
That's different. In front of strangers, I go all like jelly. I can't do it.
I'll do it with you.
You will?
Neither of you are going anywhere. The only way you can leave is to get adopted, and I can't imagine anyone in their right minds wanting you.
Now finish the washing up.
Reject.
Good night, Molly. What's the matter?
They said I was a reject. That nobody wanted me.
Oh, Molly. Don't listen to them. Come here. Your parents loved you very much.
They died. They didn't dump me.
You were very special to them. You still are. To all of us. Now you need to get to bed. You've got that cross-country run tomorrow. Go on.
Just believe in yourself, Molly.
Run with me, Molly.
I'm not a reject.
Come on, Molly. Why don't you just try?
Don't you start on me, Rocky. I hate this place.
Don't forget practice. 4 o'clock.
Believe in myself. Believe in myself. I am like no one else. If they could see for themselves. I'm so good. Believe in myself. Believe in myself. Twisted eyes on the shelf. If they could see for themselves. I'm so far from where you are.
It's alright for you to feel in a town. I wish I was you.
So these are due back on the 15th. Enjoy.
Thank you very much.
I'll see you soon. Hello, Molly. It's in the usual place.
Thanks, miss.
Where are you, Molly?
Hypnotism, an ancient art explained by Dr. H. Logan, 1908.
I know it very well, but as I said, we've been unable to locate.
Now listen, I reserved that book.
I can only.
I came all the way from London.
Professor, please.
I've been looking for that book for a very long time.
Could I ask you to keep your voice down, please?
The only surviving copy is here, in this library. Find it! That's your job, isn't it?
Professor, please.
What sort of incompetent librarian are you?
Voice down.
Right. Find it myself. H's. Eyes, hamsters, hairdressing, hippies. Hypnotism, here we go. History of hypnotism. Helpful tips on hypnotism. Somebody's borrowed it and it hasn't been properly booked out.
Nobody has borrowed it, Professor. I can only assume it's lost. I am genuinely very fascinated.
You're about to depart on an incredible journey.
It's been all the week after. I need it now.
Professor, I'm afraid it may very well be lost.
I suggest you find it. Otherwise, Briersville will be looking for a new librarian.
Perhaps I was a little too hasty, Professor. Let me look
That's
again.
That's it. That's the book. Hey, wait! You! Come back!
Well, we said to her, that is not the sort of dress you should be wearing to a funeral.
Moon.
To mind my own business.
You did. You! Shoot. You! Where's this road lead?
Hypnotism is an ancient art. It has been used since the earliest times to dissolve fear and pain, to change people's lives. An experienced hypnotist will find that hypnotism can be achieved with a simple glare of the eyes. Only a few will have the true gift. To find out whether you have this talent, try to put yourself into a trance. All you need is a looking glass so you can stare into your eyes. Stare hard. When you feel as if you are floating, your mind is in a trance. Focus completely on your reflection.
Quiet, Petula. Why do you have to be so mean all the time?
Think of the animal you are going to hypnotize. Find its voice, copy it.
From now on, no angry Petula.
Wow! It actually worked! You and me are friends now.
There you are.
You said you'd practice with me.
You'll never believe
I waited over an hour.
I'm sorry, Rocky. I
don't care why, Molly. Just don't let me down again next time.
I won't.
Come on, let's go to dinner. Fish vomit soup all week.
We'll see about that.
Help wanted. Why bother, really? Nobody likes it anyway.
Smells nice.
Oh. What?
Your own recipe.
Of course it's my own flipping recipe.
Copy your subject. This will help put them into a trance.
Blooming creepy you are. It's too flaming hot. Here, what's you doing?
It is too flaming hot in here. We need a break.
Suppose it won't hurt. I do need a blooming break.
There we go. Brown, brown. Nice and relaxing.
I'm beginning to feel a bit soupy.
You are feeling sleepy. Feel how relaxed you are.
What awfully nice eyes you've got.
Yours must be feeling very heavy right now. Just take a few nice breaths in. Three, two, one.
Amazing.
Amazing.
Edna, from now on, you'll be the friend of me, Molly Moon, and
You're not going to cook fish or chicken feet. You're going to cook something delicious. From Italy.
Delicious. From Italy.
Bon appetito.
It's really yummy.
Benvenuta a
cena.
Spaghetti primavera, formaggio e pomodoro.
It's really good. It's got garlic in it. I love garlic.
This is great. Linda, have you gone mad?
No. I happen to have a love of Italy deep in my soul. And sometimes it comes out.
It's never come out before.
First time for everything.
Deep in her soul.
Sandy, oh my.
What? Sandy, oh my.
Could you take it upstairs, please? You should try it in Saddiston. It's really nice.
Yeah,
I don't do spaghetti.
It's great.
Quiet, please.
It's delicious, Edna.
Thank you, Edna.
Shouting is not permitted, Moon. See me in my study after dinner. Oi!
Molly's just complimented me on my food.
You owe her an apology.
Edna?
What?
I think you need a little holiday.
Actually, Miss Addison, I think she might be onto something. This is the first nutritious meal that the kids have had in years.
Yeah,
it's lovely.
It's really good.
This is a letter from a Mr. and Mrs. Alabaster. They will be coming to visit us, and they've asked me to recommend one of you older children, and only one of you, for adoption. Oh, it's not every day that wealthy, nice people do this sort of thing, and you certainly don't deserve them. They're coming on Saturday afternoon. All you children will be presented to them, but who I choose will be the child they adopt. Hazel. Better luck next time. Rosa.
Yes.
It's your lucky day. Make sure you look presentable.
I don't want to go without you.
We won't let that happen. We'll always stick together. Don't worry. I'll think of a plan.
You promised that Molly and Rocky would be adopted together.
Don't tell me my job, Crinkleberry.
I've raised those two since the day they arrived, and I'm not going to stand by and see what little happiness they have ripped away.
Well, it's my decision. Anyway, they need to learn to stand on their own two feet, apart from each other, if necessary.
If you go through with it, I will be forced to talk to the governing board. And they won't stand for you treating the children's futures like this.
Moon. Moon. I know where you live, Moon.
There you are.
Hello, Mum.
So where have you been all week, huh?
I'm organising a job. Big one. I think you'll be impressed.
Oh, I doubt that. You'll never be a master criminal like me, you know.
I'm going to rob Shoring's bank.
Shoring's? You mean the jewellery people? Mm. Are you mad? It's like Fort Knox. Anyway, I heard that the Craig gang have got their eyes on it.
Oh. What if I told you that I'm going to get there before them? And what if I told you that I'm going to use hypnosis?
What are you talking about?
There's this girl, and she has a book. Tells you everything.
A girl and a book. What are you talking
Mum,
about?
This book's amazing. It has the power to choose who becomes a master hypnotist. And it's going to choose me. I just have to get the book off the girl. Her name is Moon. She lives in an orphanage.
Moon, hypnotism, robbing banks.
Mum,
are you on medication? Stick to the small stuff.
I don't want to sell off other people's stolen things for the...
Oh, shut up and get on with it.
I'll show her. Hardwick House.
Start with the sewage tank.
I want it finished before the children get back from school. Revolting.
Lull your subject into a trance. Echo their feelings. See the world as they do.
Addison's mad.
Beware. Angry people are difficult to hypnotize. Find something that they are deeply attached to. This thing could be a hobby, a piece of music, a favorite belonging. Your patterns.
Do these light bulbs need replacing? Could you give me a hand? I can't quite reach.
Oh, of course, Miss Addison.
The children need to see where they're going.
Don't want there to be a nasty accident, do we? Accidents happen.
Is she dead?
No, of course she isn't dead. It's just a little trip. Come on up to bed, all of you. Come on, nothing to look at. Get well soon, Trinkets. But not too soon.
Oh, I say. You're very forward, Mr. Knockman.
Gutters, I'm just, you know...
You're the last handyman. Just use the stairs.
Come and have a sherry.
Tomorrow, don't be late.
We're so pleased you and Mrs. Alabaster have decided to adopt one of our children. We look forward to seeing you this afternoon.
Come on.
Goodbye.
Come on, we better go.
You go ahead. I'll catch you up.
What? I've got something to do. Just make sure we're on last.
But
I promise I'll be there. Just go.
If you've come to try to change my mind about Rocky, don't bother. Stop ogling me, girl. You look demented.
I've always admired your fashion sense, Miss Addison. Your choice of patterns. Really original. And you make it work so well.
Yes, I've always enjoyed combining patterns and colours and patterns.
The patterns on your skirt work so perfectly with the shapes on your shirt.
You're right. Some people would say they clash, but I see you've understood my pants. My point.
I'm really nervous, you know.
But Molly will turn up. You know that, don't you?
But what if she doesn't show up?
I'm going to get the mummies.
Well, look who it is.
Loser.
I wish we had parents someday. You remember how it was when you were a child, when you were happy? You'll be nice. To everyone.
Yes. Only nice.
And you'll need someone to play with. Here's your new best friend.
Lost your girlfriend? Scared to go out there all on your own, Z?
No one's going to want to adopt you, loser boy.
Nobody leave.
Shut the front door.
I'm not saying pretty please.
Shut the front door.
Gonna bring you to your knees.
Shut the front door.
Cause I'ma sting you like a bee.
Shut the front door.
You're going to tell the Alabasters to adopt Hazel, not Rocky. Understand?
I understand.
Nobody leave.
Shut the front door.
Cause I mean business.
You're going to change your records to say that me and Rocky will be adopted together.
Abandoned at birth. Left on doorstep. No contact since.
You were left on the front steps in a moon's marshmallow box. That's how you got your name.
So they didn't die. They left me.
Rocky!
And now the final act of the competition, a singing duo, Molly Moon and Rocky Scarlet.
It's not fair. We were the best. We should have won.
fuck he did. He didn't do it.
Uh-oh.
Feels like we've gone back in time.
Not long to wait now.
Yes, we hope you'll accept this contribution. Perhaps some laptops for the children. iPads, maybe.
Oh, Teddy says thank you.
He's very welcome.
Jammy Dodger.
Nice car, isn't it?
There you all are. How nice. It's so lovely to see you. Now,
Hazel. Quick sticks. Mr. and Mrs. Alabaster have arrived from London.
Run upstairs and brush your hair. You're now my first choice.
She's gone bonkers. That's my teddy.
Here we are.
Thank you. That's fine.
Children! Now, there's one that I'd especially like you to meet.
Hello, I'm Rocky. How lovely to see you. I've really been looking forward to meeting you.
No, Rocky.
Nice someone to meet you, Rocky. Ooh, come over here.
Tell me about yourself.
No, I think there's been a tiny little bit of a mistake.
I like cross-country running, reading history, and playing the guitar. Classical, mostly.
Me too.
No! Stop! Rocky, stop! What are you doing? That should be Hazel.
I just want to go, Molly.
Go! You can't go! I changed everything for the better!
You promised you'd be there for me and you weren't. You promised.
We have to go now, Richard.
Don't worry, Molly. He'll come back.
You didn't see the look in his eyes.
Then you've got to go and find him.
I can't just leave you all.
Don't worry about us. We'll manage. Just bring him back as soon as you can. We need him here for Christmas. I'll do it.
Give me that book.
What book?
No, just...
All right, then!
Beastly thing!
No, Petula, go back!
No!
Where are you going?
London. But this is a chartered coach. You can't come on.
But I really need to get to London.
Not on this coach, you won't. Now, get back to your mummy.
I don't have one. I'm an orphan. And I need to get on this coach. And you really want to help me.
Well, I don't know if I can...
Hey! Stop! Stop! Stop the bus! Gah!
Believe in myself, things that I felt like no one else in the world.
We won't see Rocky today, Petula. I'll have to find the address. We'll need to find somewhere to stay.
Believe in myself, dream for myself. See for myself what can be. 'Cause I need to find what's out there for me. Maybe this time I'll be fine. Maybe this time.
I will. Thank you. Bye. We've got some more hypnotizing to do, Petula. Do you work here?
Yes.
Hotel's finest suite. There are controls for temperature, lighting, and entertainment.
And there's even a dining room. Whoa. Is that Big Ben?
Yes, it is. We cater to your every need. A dog walker, if you require it, use of the hotel Bentley, and your own private balcony.
Wow. This is amazing. Rocky's going to love this place.
You know, I finally got out of that place, it's true. Old friends are just such a waste of space.
That coach was heading to London. Where would it have dropped her off?
I could be like her, Petula. You. Everybody loves you now, you're so cute.
Good morning, London. What a beautiful day for Christmas shopping. Let's rock.
So for Mr. Duncan Alabaster, it's 12 Montparnasse Avenue, London, W163SD. Okay?
Thank you.
Enjoy your day, Milo.
I think I know how you and your dog got in here. Don't worry, I won't tell anyone. An orphan, aren't you?
Why do you think
I can tell. We have to be tougher than the rest, don't we?
You're an orphan too. You're not throwing me out.
Let's just take it one day at a time, shall we?
Thank you.
Oh, Miss Moon, please, don't hypnotize any more of my staff.
Okay, here we go, cowboy. One portion of Angela's organic homemade muesli coming right up. Good catch. Okay, we've got, let's see, low fat, soy milk or rice milk? Yogurt? Probiotic?
Morning, Richard. I hope you had a good night's sleep. Now, I hope you've got everything you want. Svetlana, she can rustle up anything if you want her to.
No, it's fine, thank you, Mrs. Alabaster.
Oh, call me Angela. Or maybe Mummy?
Hello? Yes, yes, absolutely. Richard, I think you've got a visitor.
For me?
Come on, don't keep the little lady waiting.
Mommy!
Rocky!
What are you doing here?
Nice suit. Nice hair, too.
How did you find me? Petula, what's she doing here?
It's a long story. I've got so much to tell you. You'll die when you see where we're staying. It's amazing. I can hypnotize people. I can do amazing things. We can do amazing things together. Everything we dreamt about.
I'm not going anywhere.
Rocky, I'm sorry I let you down at the time.
It doesn't matter. They're my family.
Richard?
They're not your family.
Richard?
I'm your family.
Richard?
Everything okay?
Yes, Dad. Just coming.
Richard! Dad! Wait. This is where I'm staying. It's brilliant. You can see the whole of London from...
Goodbye, Molly. I'm sorry. I've got to go.
What are we going to do, Petula? Well, I guess it's just you and me now. She's everywhere.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Davina Natel, right here on the Charlie Cooper Morning Show. So, Davina, tell us about your latest venture.
Well, Charlie, I'm in a TV special. So many people loved me. We just wanted to find a way to share me with everyone.
So many people love me, I'm just going to explode.
It's going to be an amazing show.
It's so nice to be popular.
And you're working with director Barry Ricks, London's star maker.
Oh, he's the best. We have very big plans. In fact, so big. We're looking for extra singers and dancers. So if you want to be a part of my amazing show, we're holding auditions here at the studios today.
Auditions?
Hello, you aspiring Davinas. Well, we're looking forward to
it. On TV.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Petula, I could be a star. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the famous Miss Molly Moon.
I want to talk to Barry.
Right, now! Tell Barry we're coming to see him.
Too right we're coming to see him.
She can't work this way.
And tell Barry that Miss Nutell says she can't work this way.
Barry, where are you? I'm done with this.
Davina Nutell.
Wait a minute, Davina.
I'm telling you, Barry.
Davina.
The moves are all wrong. I'm constantly being crashed into or upstaged.
She is the star.
I'll change the
she
routine.
Up front,
Davina.
And centre, the entire
Davina,
time.
Sweetheart, I'm sure
I'm
we can sort it out.
Find me another choreographer. Cancel the auditions.
Get rid of them. Okay, guys, back to the holding room.
Come on, guys.
Oh, no.
this close. Why can't she? Believe in myself. I believe in myself. I'm like no one else. If they could see for themselves, I'm a star.
Your dishes are cancelled. Scram.
Mr. Ritz.
Disappear or I'll call security.
You're the best director in the business.
Who are you?
Must be difficult. People expect so much from you. Your singing was amazing. You could have been... You should be a star.
You really think so?
I like that bit. If they could see for themselves.
Yeah, I love that bit too.
If they could see for themselves, I'm a star.
Yeah. I'm telling you, Charlie, she's the real deal. The whole gift wrap package. I'm being deadly serious. I want her to replace Davina.
And we'll call the show Marvelous. Everyone's gonna love her.
Do you really think they will?
Don't speak. Look at those eyes. I tell you, you are a star.
Of course the boot's not too small. You're just not putting it on right. I can't believe he did that to me. It's not my fault.
Don't worry, darling. Mummy's going to sort it all out.
Ow! For God's sake, careful. Moron. Idiot.
I'm done with this.
That's my song. That's my song.
Not anymore.
Molly, darling, we really must hit the ground running. Photo shoot this afternoon, more tomorrow, and Charlie Cooper show tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Molly Moon!
Hi, everybody.
And who do we have here?
Petulia, my best friend.
Well, it may be a mystery why Davina was sacked, but... Well, I'm sure you'll all agree. Her replacement is mesmerising.
Thank you. I really like it, too. I'll need a new bag to go with my new shoes. I'll need lots more dresses for my parties. Oh! I'll need some new jewellery. Me.
your show.
Petula, darling, Petula, not the time, not the place, not your show. Hello, can someone? You are marvellous.
What has she done to them?
I thought we'd need weeks of rehearsal. London's not going to know what's in it.
Crikey. I don't think I can do this. But being famous is nice.
You can't dance. You can't sing. You can't just steal things from people. I worked hard for this.
Give me a second to explain.
You've paid them off or something. Whatever you've done, I promise you, you're not going to get away with it. And these are mine. And stop staring at me! The audience will know you're rubbish.
To hypnotize a crowd of people, all you need is a looking glass. Stare into your own eyes. If successful, your face will appear to change shape and your eyes will feel glowing. This is the intensity needed for crowd hypnosis. You'll be able to hypnotize a crowd of 10.
10? That's all.
I don't know if I can do this, Petula.
Whoa.
Okay.
Wish you were here, Mummy.
Show you, Mum. I'll hypnotize my way in. Need that book?
Molly Moon.
Molly, it's me, Jerry.
Jerry! How did you know where I was?
We heard about you on the radio.
How's Mrs. Strinkleberry? She's getting better. She's still in hospital.
Is Miss Addison looking after you? Now that she's been nice?
Kind of. She's still behaving funny. She lets us look after ourselves now.
What about Edna?
She's left.
She's gone to open a restaurant in Italy.
Did you find Rocky?
Yes. He's happy where he is.
When are you coming home, Molly? 1 second, Jerry. I'll have to take this other call.
Hello?
Your limousine is downstairs, Miss Moon.
Thank you. Jerry,
I have to go now.
I'll talk to you later. Bye. Well, she had to go.
That's my teddy.
Teddy's mine now.
Sure, it's really a sellout.
You better believe it, babe. And millions will be watching on TV. Millions. You ready? Let's do this.
To name as many things that Rick Astley is never gonna do.
Hello, Macapaca.
Split?
It's no flower at all, Rob!
Of course.
If I heard that name before.
Well, the girl in the book.
You know, Richard's guitar's coming on well. I think we'll go to play after the meal.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if this this turkey had been successful, we'd be spending a lot of time over. Need to think about a boarding school for Richard.
Really? Why aren't we taking him with us?
Oh, good to know. Disrupt his education and his music studies.
Hello, Mum.
Have you found her yet?
Not yet, no.
You might try looking for her at Portland Studios. She is about to become the biggest TV star in the world.
Molly Moon? What do you mean?
She's got that book with her, and I think she's been learning from it.
What was the name of that studio, Mum?
Portland Studios.
How do you spell that, Mum?
P-O...
Stop. Ruhe bitte.
May I proudly present the talents of Richard Alabaster.
I can't really do this.
Show some backbone, Richard. Don't let yourself down.
Come on, Richard.
And I'm not going to any boarding school.
Do you think it's too late to send him back?
Okay, peppermint tea, coffee, wine?
Yes.
Five minutes to showtime.
I've done what I can, Petula. It's got to work.
Take your seats, ladies and gentlemen. The show is about to begin.
Oh, Belle, come on, it's starting!
I know, I can't wait to see her! She's so famous!
Please let this work. Hello, everybody. It's nice to meet you. You've all been wondering about me. Well, look into my eyes. You want to see and hear the most marvelous, fabulous, spectacular, thrilling show ever. And you will. You are going to love this.
Take a look at me. I'm-
Richard!
I'm not Richard. I'm Rocky.
You are an ungrateful, spoilt, childish little fool.
How dare you lock this door?
Hmm? You're ours now, Richard.
The only one will trust you. If you fly out, we can visit it in the holiday.
Richard, I am going to count to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm warning you! 6, 7, 8. Richard!
Hypnotize a crowd. So that's how you do it.
Who are you?
Who am I? Do you live under a rock? Get out or I'll call security.
Give me that book, darling.
You must be joking. Horrible little man.
Just... it's alright.
Creep!
Give me the book. Come on. Give me the book. Give it.
Do you mean this? Ah!
Have you got the book yet, or are you just twiddling your thumbs?
Having rather a difficult day, actually, Mum.
Now listen up to what I'm going to tell you.
I have it on
very good authority that Craig and his boys are going to rob Shoring's bank.
Tomorrow morning, first thing.
So after they've done all the heavy work...
you are going to rob them.
And you are going to use some of all that hypnotism
stuff that you've been blathering on about.
Haven't quite got the book... from the girl.
You don't
Mama.
Need the book. You just need the girl.
She's already learnt it.
You mean kidnap her?
Davina. He needs his head examined.
Seriously,
We've got better kids in the infant class.
Molly Moon, you are a star. Welcome to showbiz.
Molly, how does it feel to be toast of the town?
I feel right at home.
But do you think fame will change you?
Of course it won't.
Your family must be so proud. Are they here tonight?
They couldn't make it.
You become a star overnight, everything a girl could ask for. So tell me, if there was one person in the whole world you could share all this with, who would it be?
All those people. I fooled them. I cheated, Petula. I feel so bad about it. They don't really love me. Not like my real friends. I miss Rocky Petula.
There you are, Molly. You need to get dressed now for the after-show party. I'll take Petula. Right.
Davina? Oh.
I know what you're up to, and I know your secret. You just hypnotize people to get what you want. 6 years of ballet lessons, tap lessons, singing lessons. And you just bat your eyelashes and waltz in.
You're right, Davina. This is yours. I just wanted what you had. You're the star. I thought I could make everything great, but I didn't at all. I don't want this anymore.
This is yours.
Thank you.
I was a bit of a monster.
We've both made mistakes, Davina. It's time I went home.
But aren't you an orphan?
Yes, I am.
Then you haven't got a family.
But that doesn't mean I don't have people who love me. And I miss them. I'm giving all this up.
Molly! Sweetie, what are you wearing? There's a Charlie Cooper interview in half an hour. We've got the after-show party. There's this agent I really...
I'm leaving the show, Barry. In fact, I'm leaving show business.
Molly, no. Don't try comedy. Just focus on singing and dancing right now.
You said to be a star, I must really want it. Well, I realised I don't. My friends are more important. And I miss them. So I quit.
You ungrateful little brat.
I'm sorry, Barry.
You're nobody, Moon. You know that? I had to think I got rid of a real star for you.
Why didn't you go and get her back? She's over there in the dressing room.
Ask Davina back. She'll never agree. Anyway, she's a monster.
She's pretty brilliant. Much better than me. And she deserves another chance. Imagine the publicity. Barry Ricks masterminds the comeback of Davina, darling Natel.
Brainwave. Davina in a new show. Massive extravaganza. Do you feel it? Musical extravaganza. With orchestras, dancing girls, the whole lot. What do you think? You like it?
Yes.
When can we start rehearsal?
Anytime you like.
I'm a genius.
You are.
Davina. Darling, you look fabulous. So much as
a star. Petula. Rocky! Molly! I missed you. I've missed you too, Rocky.
This young man came to the hotel looking for you. I knew you were here, so I brought him along.
Thank you.
We have to look after our friends. You understand that? Now travel home safely.
The Alabasters could never be my family. They were horrible. But what about you? You're a star now.
It's not for me. I thought I could make everything better.
What are you talking about?
I found this book.
This book taught you how to hypnotize people.
Yes, it was fun at first. Edna with the spaghetti, and Addiston. And then it all started going wrong. Come, best get back to the orphanage. I hypnotized the director to pick me. And all the audience.
All the audience? But that's amazing, Molly. You were on television all over the world.
Miss Moon, this letter has just arrived for you.
Thank you.
Petula, she's been kidnapped. I've got to go to the meeting point alone. I have to be there by dawn.
Let's call the police.
You can't tell the police.
They'll find out what I've been doing.
You can't just go alone. We need a plan, okay? He doesn't know about me. That's our advantage.
He said come alone.
When do we start doing what grown-ups say?
Come on, then.
Listen.
Petula. You. It's you. Why are you wearing those?
I know what you learned in that book. And you won't do it to me. I have a little job for you.
Do what you're told, and you and the dog go free. Come on.
Rob a bank? I can't rob a bank. I'm not a criminal.
Don't fool yourself. You conned your way into fame and fortune, didn't you? How would that look on a billboard?
I was just trying...
You're a natural, all right? And we're not robbing a bank. We are robbing the people who are robbing a bank. Craig. Wait for Craig's men to come out of the bank in the security truck. It will be stuffed with jewels. Then you do as you're told.
Where did she come from?
Where did she go?
Where your son hits the big time! Ah! The dog stays in the box. Sit there. There! What is this? What's this?
Iris recognition.
Access denied. Step away from the vehicle. Step away from the vehicle. Step away from the vehicle.
Stop that! Get in!
Mom!
Hello, Sonny. Going somewhere?
Craig, you're in this together, but he's your biggest rival.
Tony and I joined forces just before we joined forces. Didn't we, Tony? Oh, you're so cute.
You're old enough to be, isn't it?
Think about the end of that sentence. Well, it's a pleasure to finally meet you. You are a clever girl.
Stay where you are, pal.
You think we don't know what we're dealing with here? You were fantastic at hypnotizing half the world, let alone my two guys at the bank. But now, we have something that you're gonna have to do for us.
Something that we knew about, but my stupid son didn't.
Iris recognition.
Come on. I know you can do
Step
it.
Away from the
I can't do it. It's a machine.
Concentrate. Otherwise, vehicle. That dog of yours is dog meat. Go on.
Iris recognition. Unable
I know
to
you
identify.
Can't. Stop fooling around.
Unable to identify. Unable to do. Identification.
Iris identification.
Access granted.
Yes! Bingo. Put them both in the lockup and let's get this stuff in the car.
Okay, babe.
Mom, what about me? Mom!
Get in there.
What about you, son?
All the work I put into this. Double-crossed by my own mother.
And now your mum's dumped you. And it's all gone wrong. Don't expect me to feel sorry for you, Nockman. You stole something that wasn't yours, and you cheated.
You're one to talk.
I guess you've both got yourselves into a mess. You're right. I cheated too. I was wrong. And I've lost my best friend. Again.
Perhaps not.
Hmm? Rocky! Shh.
He wants you to lock it again with your eyes. Using the mirrors when they're both in the back of the truck.
Come on, Tony, don't just stand there. Come on, help me. We've got one more load and we're done. Take this.
Listen, you look at this. Put it in here, put it in here. Over here, babe.
Apply lock.
Yes!
Oi!
It worked!
That little monster.
Molly, you did it! Rocky, that was brilliant!
Let's get you out of here.
You don't want to mess with
him. What about him?
I don't think he's a problem anymore. But we do have to deal with them.
Trace, talk to your boy. Lockie,
you know,
darling,
they took the glass.
I'm your mother. I
Look,
love
man,
you.
Listen to your mother.
Oh, they look happy now. We've got to get those jewels back. Don't we, Nockman?
Yeah. Mystery surrounds the discovery of two notorious criminals found in Trafalgar Square this morning. Police believe they masterminded yesterday's Shoring's bank robbery.
The jewels from the heist were recovered along with 847 garden gnomes. Now there's a Christmas puzzle to solve. Tell them you're going to Briarsville.
Yeah.
And they'll tell you where to change trains.
So what are you going to do now, Nockman? Find another bank to rob?
I don't want to end up like my mum.
In prison.
Which is all I had.
You must have friends. We can be your friends. You know where we are. Come and visit us.
Thank you. I will.
Okay, now, come on. You'll be late.
Merry Christmas.
Did we spend all of the reward money on Christmas presents?
Yes, we did. It looks deserted. Oh, I hope everything's all right.
We won't wait for that long.
When Jerry called, now I think about it, he sounded so worried. Oh dear, where is everybody?
Molly! Rocky!
James!
Priscilla! Molly! Rocky, you're home!
You're back! Molly! I missed you!
Yay! Yeah.
What are you doing back here?
I thought you were adopted. I'd rather be here.
Oh, we thought you left us, Molly.
No! London was amazing. But there was something missing.
Spaghetti?
No, not spaghetti, Ruby. You! I missed all of you.
Wow.
Even you, Hazel.
Thanks, Molly.
Do you all get presents?
Of course. There's something for everyone.
Yay! Who's Alistair?
She's in her room. She hardly ever comes out anymore.
So who's looking after you?
I am.
Oh, Mrs. Trinkleberry!
Back this morning when I heard what had been going on. And to make sure all you sprouts were all right.
Alistair was horrible to you.
I think she's forgotten about that. She's not been quite herself. But anyway, she's leaving today.
Miss Addison.
Molly Moon.
Are you still hypnotised?
I'm just waiting for a taxi. I think I've been making a bit of a fool of myself. And I know I haven't been very nice to you. Molly. It's something I should have given to you that I never have. Sorry. When you were found on the doorstep, was in the box with you. Your mother wanted to keep you, but she couldn't. She did love you, Molly, that's for certain. Now go back and join the others.
My darling daughter.
I haven't seen you for some time.
I have something of yours.
Thank you, Molly. I hope it helped.
How did you know? It has. I mean, it really has.
It's funny how it has a way of getting into the right hands.
You left it there for me to find, didn't you?
Sometimes it needs a little help. Finding the right person.
Who are you?
I'm just the librarian. Now, hadn't you better be getting back? It's Christmas Eve.
I probably should. Thank you.
You're very welcome. Oh, and Molly, it wasn't the hypnotism that made you special. It was you.
There was one more thing to sort out.
Mrs. Twinkleberry, We need to ask you something. We love you, and we need you here. Please, would you stay and look after us?
I'd love to.
Sometimes you must go to a place far away. See things you don't know, the games you must play to find your way home.
Brilliant.
I tried a new nest, got into a mess, was put to the test. You guys are the best. I found my way home.
Whoa, didn't know the world was calling. And I'm shy.
believe in myself. I believe in myself. I am like no one else. If they could see for themselves, I'm a star. I'm a star that shines so brightly. That's me. There are places that I long to see. I've only pictured them in make-believe. Oh, those people that will let me be the one and only me. Taking one step at a time to claim what was always mine. If I listen to the stars, they say it's my night, it's my day. Believe in myself, I believe in myself. I am like no one else. If they could see for themselves, I'm a star.